Once again, I welcome you all for this online class. And today we are continuing with part 2 of history lesson 2. And the title of our lesson is Art and Architecture of Tamil Nadu. And today we are continuing with our different periods of epochs regarding the Tamil Nadu. So, and today we are continuing with the early Chola epoch, that is the early period of Chola age. So, the Cholas came into importance. They came to the history during the time of AD 850. Okay, so they, even though before 850 they were available, but they got importance of the world only during the 850 AD. Under the king named Vijayalaya, he made the Chola, early period of Chola epoch, to attain great importance. Okay, and he continued to govern the region. After Vijayalaya, the Chola, early Chola period continued for about 400 years. So what are the some of the important events, important identifications regarding the Chola age? Okay, first important thing is, during the early Chola epoch, the temple at Dadapuram, which is near Dindivanam in Tamil Nadu, it was very much important because it was built, the architecture of the temple was built in the style of Sembiyan Mahadevi. She was a deity, goddess. Okay, and Sembiyan is a method of style followed by the architect during the Chola early period. Okay, that is, in the Sembiyan style of temples, you could see many number of niches. You know what is niches, isn't it? It is a rectangle shaped portion which is left to draw or keep any idol images in a continuous manner, like how you see a train. It looks like a long train with rectangular compartments inside which images or idols may be placed. So regarding the Sembiyan style, the niches will be very long. Okay, so the one example of a temple which followed the Sembiyan Mahadevi style is Thirupparambiyam. Okay, so this Thirupparambiyam temple followed the Sembiyan Mahadevi system of architecture. Okay, after early Chola age, it was continued with it was followed by later Chola age. Okay, so the regarding the later Chola age, so the Chola architecture, it started to progress slowly, it started to develop slowly, and it attained its greatness. Okay, so two important great architectural achievements regarding the Chola age. One is Tanjavur big temple, which is Bragadishwara temple, and the other one is Chola Gangaikonda Cholapuram temple. Okay, Gangaikonda Cholapuram temple. So so the Bragadishwara temple, it was dedicated, it was built in honor of the Lord Shiva, and it was completed around 1009 AD. Okay, and it is the fitting memorial to material achievements of the time of Rajaraja Chola. So this famous temple was built by Rajaraja Chola and it was a great achievement which is celebrated by the architects of the architectural achievement of the whole world. So during the time when the Thanjavur temple was constructed, it was the biggest temple ever built. Okay, and it had 216 feet vimana. Okay, vimana is a the round shaped part of the temple which is situated in the top of the temple. The round shape which is at the top of the temple, we call it vimana, isn't it? And this is one of the tallest architectural development of the whole world. And because of its massive height, the shikara is also called Dakshina Meru. Okay, and in this temple there is a huge Nandi statue, and the size of the Nandi statue is about 16 feet long and 13 feet height, and it was made by using a single rock. Okay, so the next important temple is Gangaikonda Cholapuram. So the Gangaikonda Cholapuram, it was the capital city of the Chola Empire for nearly 200 years. Okay, so after the 250 years, they were defeated by the Pandyas. So the Brihadeeswara temple in Gangaikonda Cholapuram, it was built by Rajendra Chola, and it was equally worthy and important like the Brihadeeswara temple of Thanjavur. And the height of the temple is 55 meters, and the sanctum inside the temple, it had two stories building, as in the temple which is in Thanjavur. So the outer walls, they have many projections with niches and recesses on three sides. So there were a lot of niches, rectangular shaped portions. Okay, and in niches there are images of Shiva, Vishnu and other goddess. Okay, these are some of the important informations regarding the earlier and later Chola epoch. And another one more temple is a temple located in the Dharasuram, which is near Kumbakonam. So this temple which is located in Dharasuram near Kumbakonam is built by the later Cholas during the later Chola period. And the name of the temple is Airavadishwara temple. Okay, it was a temple built for Lord Shiva, and also there is God Indra's elephant statue available in this temple, and it was built by Rajaraja II. So the temple is another landmark for the great architectural achievements of the Chola Empire. And there is a Maha Mandapam, which is elaborate structure, and the entire structure looks like a Ratha. Ratha means it is like a wagon, because it had four wheels at the four corners of the mandapam. The sanctums and the pillars have many sculptures which are miniatures of various mythological figures. Miniatures means it is a small size of great gods, mythological figures, gods. So in taking copy of those huge gods, they made miniature, that is small sized god pictures, and they made it in the sanctum and pillars of the temple. And a compound wall, a large compound wall runs around the temple with a gopuram. Okay, with that Chola is ended. Next we move on to the later Pandyas. So after the Cholas, they were occupied by the Pandya kings. So the most important temple regarding the Pandya dynasty was Pillayarpatti temple, which is located in Karaikudi in Tamil Nadu. It was a cave temple. temple built in a cave, okay, during the 13th century. And this temple is more important for its cultural and also it had many inscriptions. So it is famous for the sculptures, that is idols and images carved by the people, and also it had many inscriptions on the caves, and a beautiful Ganesha statue which is visible in the right side of your slide. This beautiful Ganesha statue was carved facing the entrance. Okay, then the Desi Vinayaga in the cave inscription is the with two arms and trunk turning to the right. Okay, after the Pandyas, we move on to the Vijayanagara epoch, which is the very important and prominent period of the Tamil Nadu age. Vijayanagara epoch. So during the Vijayanagara epoch, a new form of construction came into existence. It is named as Mandapam. Okay, so the Mandapam is a new form of building structure brought by the Vijayanagara kings. Okay, so so in this Mandapa there will be a huge space around. So in the space they used to carry the gods every year. They used to carry and they make some kind of in Tamil what you call Urvalam. Okay, they take it for Urvalam often once in a year. So in the Vijayanagara kind of structure there will be the Mandapas are meant for public rituals with one in the east and serving as waiting room for the devotees which adorn the large temples. So there at the outer place of the Mandapam there are huge space available for the devotees to wait for their worship. Okay, so these Mandapas attract attention for its monolithic pillars. So the pillars found in this type of Mandapas, they were made of single rock, and on these pillars there are idols of horses, lions and goddesses, where gods and goddesses were carved. Okay, and there is a Kalyana Mandapam, a marriage hall at Kanchipuram, which is the Varadaraja Perumal temple, and in Vellore there is Jalakandeswar temple. These are notable examples of the great architectural works of the Vijayanagara kings. And the most celebrated of these Mandapams in temple is Madurai is Pudu Mandapam. Okay, in continuation of the Vijayanagara age, the main features of the Vijayanagar and the Nayak architecture are the decorated Mandapas, ornamental pillars, okay, pillars which were designed with many inscriptions, and life-size images, gopuras, prakras, music pillars, floral works and stone windows. These are the important and prominent achievements of the Vijayanagar kings, Vijayanagar and Nayak kings during the 15th and 17th centuries. And also there are tanks attached to these temples, and the gateways to the temples are constructed from the four directions with massive gopuras. So the entrance will be at the four directions of the huge temple. And the most important achievements of the Vijayanagar age kings was the 1000 pillar Mandapam, which is situated in Madurai, and the name of the temple is Meenakshi Sundareshwara temple at Madurai. Okay, this is the most famous achievement of the Vijayanagar kings, because it had 1000 pillars thousand pillows in the mantapam, which will be very identically carved with a brilliant architectural work it was made. So even the tourists all over the world, they were attracted to see the greatness of these thousand pillars, which is found in the same shape, and there is nothing problem or nothing wrong done in these pillars. Okay, so the pillars of this period are more decorative than previous period. Monolithic gigantic Yari pictures. Yari is a supernatural animal with trunk and horns. Horse pillars and life-size portraits of mythological and royal family members, common folk, animals, floral works are made. So these are different designing made in these monolithic rocks. And there is a musical pillar. There are musical pillars at this, which is a peculiar feature of this time. And also a sitting lion at the top of the pillar is a common feature in the mandapas. So the windows are carved out on walls of the sanctum and mandapam architecture of this period. Vijayanagara Noi paintings are seen at Varadaraja Perumal temple in Kanchipuram, Kudalalagar temple at Madurai, and the temple of Sri Viliputtur, Thiruvellarai, Azhagar Koyil, Thiruvannamalai and Srirangam. So the paintings of these important kings were made in these types, in these places of temples, and the paintings have the stories of Ramayana, palace scenes and mythological stories. Now let's move on to the final topic of our lesson, that is modern period after 1600 AD. So during this period, there is one of the most important kings of this era is the Sethupathis, who are the feudatories of Madurai Nayaks. Feudatories, you know, isn't it? They were small kings who paid tax to the greater kings. So these feudatories, they were named Sethupathis, and they belongs to the Madurai Nayaks rule, located in the Ramanathapuram district. They contributed much to the Ramasami temple architecture. Who? The Sethupathis, who are the feudatories of Madurai Nayaks. So in the temple of Rameswaram, there is an important corridor which is of great work, okay, which is the most important and famous thing. Okay, what is the important thing about this corridor? So this corridor is the longest, it has the longest temple corridor, and it has three sets of corridors. The outer corridor of the temple, it is almost 7 meters height, and it stretches for about 120 meters in the east and western directions. So what is the length of these corridors? It stretches about 120 meters long, which is a huge space. And the corridors to the north and the south, and on the other hand, they are nearly 195 in length. The outer corridor is remarkable for number of pillars that support it, which is over 1200 in number. Moreover, many of these pillars are decorated by ornate carvings. So in all these pillars, there are designs carved on the pillars. The innermost set of corridors is the oldest of the three. Okay, finally, the summary of the whole lesson. First, we studied about the Pallava period, which is prominent for its sculptural rock temples. The earlier Chola period is famous for its grand vimanas. The later Chola period is famous for its beautiful gopurams. And the Vijayanagar period is important for its mandapam style. Finally, the modern period is famous for the corridors. So with this children, our lesson 2 of history is completed. We'll meet in the next class. See you, bye.